Today, I want to share with you the power of typing on a path tool in Illustrator. This is such a simple tool that can really open up the door to what you can do with it in your design work. This is something I use pretty much on a daily basis, whether I'm trying to pull off a vintage badge look or just trying to lay out my type in an appealing way without having to skew it or using any warp effects. So jumping onto Illustrator, I've already got some elements laid out here for the design, and I want the text to fit within this badge, and I want it to say the Daily Grind Union. Using the ellipse tool, I'm just going to draw this out. This is what I want the type to sit on. Type that out, switch to a stroke just so I can see where this is laid out on the design, center it. All right, so going over to the type tool, type on a path, type out the daily will be the top. All right, so you've got three like anchor points or three things to kind of mess with here. You have this, which changes the direction of your type on the path, and I want it to be centered here. You got these two little ones, which are pretty hard to click on, and these are just the edges of the type or of the path. Anything that goes past this will just get cut off. So for the sake of this, I'm just gonna align that to the right and to the left. Alrighty. Let's see, scale this down just a little bit. Cool. Bring this back to 120. Looks pretty good. So I will just copy this, paste in the front, and type out the Daily Grind Union. It got cut off there. That's totally fine. I'm just going to bring this to the bottom. So as you can see, it's aligned to the baseline of the type right now. So this is on the outside and this is on the inside. I don't want that. So if you go up to type, type on a path, options, let's preview this. You have a couple things you can do here. You can skew it, 3D ribbon, stair step, which can be a pretty cool effect in some cases, gravity, but I typically use rainbow. And then we can align to the ascender, which is the top, descender, which is the bottom, center, or baseline. And for this, I want it to be the ascender. Click OK. And if I go up to the character panel, I can shift the baseline just so it matches the text above that, which looks like it's just barely touching it. Cool. And there you have it. From here, you can play with colors, play with textures. The possibilities are endless. And you don't have to just use the ellipse tool. You can use any path you want, or you can use your pen tool and just, you can go crazy with this. Like that, if you really wanted to. Anything you want. So that's the type on a path tool in Illustrator. I use this again on pretty much a daily basis. So hopefully you found this useful, and just understanding the fundamentals of this can really be applied to any design you want. If you found anything in this video useful, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to stick around for more, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch. Now let's get back to work.